how to calculate activation energy by using Arrhenius equation, and how to calculate the fraction of molecules that are having sufficient kinetic energy, what is the effect of positive and negative catalyst on the rate of the reaction with respect to activation energy, and what are the factors that decide the formation of the product, and what happens before the formation of the product, what is threshold energy, what is probability factor, what is collision frequency, and how they will affect the formation of the product. For all these questions, you will get crystal clear answer in this video. Hello students, I am your Sangmi sir, and you are watching Effortless Chemistry. In this session, we are going to start effect of catalyst on the rate of the reaction and collision theory of reaction rates. Before starting that, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get notification for all the videos. And I hope all of you are preparing well for your NEET examination, and check the description box for important playlist, tricks and shortcuts that are going to help you a lot. And if you are having any doubts, let me know in the comment box. And don't forget to like the video, because your one like keeps me motivated to make more videos for you. Let's get started. Calculation of activation energy by using Arrhenius equation. Calculation of activation energy. Already we know that Arrhenius equation, that is rate constant K equal to A into E raised to minus EA divided by RT. So here K is the rate constant or rate of the reaction, and here this A will be what? Arrhenius frequency factor, and this is also called as collision frequency here. And this term E raised to minus EA by RT, it indicates the fraction of molecules which are having a sufficient kinetic energy which can form a product upon collision. So this term is also called as Boltzmann factor here. Now applying a log on both sides, you will get a ln K equal to ln A minus EA by RT into ln E here. So here ln E become as 1, so that it can be written as ln K equal to ln A minus EA by RT. So converting this into natural log, that is log of K to the base 10 equal to log A to the base 10 minus EA divided by 2.303 RT, R into 1 by T it is. So this will be your final equation. By using this equation, we can calculate the activation energy. So here it is in the form of Y equal to MX plus C it is. So along X axis, you have to take 1 by T. And this m is what? A slope here. So you will get a negative slope. This entire term is a slope here, minus EA by 2.303 R. And this log K is taken along Y axis. And this log A is what? It is intercept here. So if you draw the graph of log K versus 1 by T, that is taken along X axis, then you will get a negative slope like this, and the slope of this line, that is a straight line, it gives slope will be equal to, this is minus EA divided by 2.303 R, and this Y intercept, it will give log A value. So this will be your log A. So by using the slope of this line, you can calculate activation energy here. Activation energy is equal to EA is equal to slope into 2.303 R with a negative sign here. So here activation energy EA will be is equal to, this is a negative slope into 2.303 R. So by using this formula, you can calculate activation energy here. So this is one formula. Next, the calculation of activation energy by using rate constant at two different temperature. Suppose if I take at a temperature T1, if I take that is activation energy by using K at two different temperature, by using K at two different temperature here. Now in this one, you can take log of K1 equal to log A minus EA divided by 2.303 R into 1 by T1. So if I take this as equation 1, at temperature T1, the rate constant will be what? K1. So at a temperature T2, log of K2 is equal to log A minus A by 2.303, this is 2.303 R into 1 by T2. So this is at temperature T2, the rate constant value is what? K2 here. So if you take equation 2 minus 1 gives this one, you will get it as a log of K2 by K1, this equal to these two terms get cancelled, and here you will get EA by 2.303 R as a common. This is EA divided by 2.303 R into 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2. So this is the equation you have to use whenever two different temperature and two different rate constant are given. So by using this equation, again you can calculate what? Activation energy. So this is what calculation of activation energy by using a rate, that is Arrhenius equation. So the next point is, from the Arrhenius theory we know that only the reacting molecules which are having a sufficient kinetic energy, or the reacting molecules which are having a threshold energy, only they will form product upon collision. The remaining reacting molecules which are not having sufficient kinetic energy, they will not form any product here. So in the given sample of the reacting mixture, the fraction of molecule which are having sufficient kinetic energy, that is calculated by using what? Arrhenius equation. Now calculation of fraction of molecule having threshold energy, calculation of fraction of molecule, fraction of molecules having threshold energy. Threshold energy is nothing but the energy that is required to form the product upon collision, that is threshold energy. So this can be calculated by using Arrhenius equation. So already you know that Arrhenius equation, K equal to A into E raised to minus EA divided by RT. This is the rate constant of the equation, that is the reaction, and this will be the Arrhenius frequency factor, so which indicates the collision frequency between the reacting molecule, and this term E raised to minus EA by RT, which indicates the fraction of molecule having sufficient kinetic energy. So the fraction of molecules which will form a product upon collision, that is indicated by what? E raised to minus EA by RT. So this is your fraction of molecule. So this term is also called as Boltzmann factor. This is also called as Boltzmann factor. Now in the problem, if they are asking calculate the fraction of molecule having sufficient kinetic energy, or which are forming a product upon collision, then you have to calculate this term here. So in order to calculate this term, I'll rearrange this one. K by A equal to E raised to minus EA divided by RT. Now taking log on both sides, that is the ln K by A equal to, this term will come this side, that is minus EA by RT ln E, and here ln E value is 1, so that this become as ln K by A equal to minus EA divided by RT. Now converting this one into a natural log, so if you convert this one into a natural log to the base 10, this become as here we'll write, that is log to the base 10 of K by A equal to minus EA divided by 2.303 RT. So by using this one, you can calculate what? A fraction of molecule that is having sufficient kinetic energy, that will be called what? K by A. Take this log this side, so this become as K by A will be equal to anti log of minus EA divided by 2.303 RT. So by using this equation, you can calculate the fraction of molecule having sufficient kinetic energy. So the next point is effect of catalyst on the rate of the reaction. Effect of catalyst on the rate of the reaction. Already we know what is the catalyst. The catalyst, the substance which alters the rate of the reaction without itself taking part in the chemical reaction, without itself undergoing any chemical change, it will alter the rate of the reaction. It may increase the rate of the reaction or it may decrease the rate of the reaction. If it is a positive catalyst, it will increase the rate of the reaction. If it is the negative catalyst, it will decrease the rate of the reaction. How it affects the rate of the reaction, we will see it now. During a chemical reaction, we know that this reactant, before getting converted into product, first it will form an unstable intermediate complex. So this unstable intermediate complex, it will decompose to give the product here. So this will be your unstable intermediate complex. And here the rate of this reaction, is inversely proportional to the activation energy. Already you know what is the activation energy here. And here, if activation energy is less, rate of the reaction will be more. If activation energy is more, rate of the reaction will be less here. Now, in this reaction, how this catalyst alters the rate of the reaction? This catalyst, it will form a temporary bond with the reactant to form an unstable intermediate complex, which is having a very, very short life, and this will decompose to give the products here. So this catalyst helps the reactant to form an unstable intermediate complex. We know that during a chemical reaction, there must be a formation of unstable intermediate complex which decomposes to give the product here. So in order to form the unstable intermediate complex, this catalyst helps the reactant so that it will form a temporary bond with the reactant so that there is a formation of unstable intermediate complex here. Here, this catalyst, it will provide an alternate pathway for the reaction by lowering the activation energy. Activation energy decreases means what happens? Rate of the reaction increases here. So here, there are two types of catalyst are there. That is, one is positive catalyst and another is what? Negative catalyst. If it is a positive catalyst, it provides an alternate pathway for the reaction and thereby it lowers the activation energy and hence it increases the rate of the reaction. If it is a negative catalyst, it increases the activation energy and thereby it decreases the rate of the reaction. Negative catalyst is nothing but poison it is. So here there are two types of catalyst here. First one, if I take positive catalyst, this positive catalyst decreases the activation energy of the reaction, thereby rate of the reaction increases. If I take a negative catalyst, this negative catalyst, it increases the activation energy of the reaction and thereby rate of the reaction decreases. And another point is a very small amount of catalyst is enough to catalyze the large amount of reactant here. Small amount of catalyst is enough to catalyze the large amount of reactant, because whenever the product is formed, that catalyst, whichever is forming a temporary bond with the reactant, that will be regenerated. Again, it will be used for what? The formation of this unstable intermediate complex. So that very small amount of catalyst is enough to catalyze the large amount of reactants. And the next point is, this catalyst catalyzes only the spontaneous reaction. Spontaneous reaction means for which Gibbs free energy value is less than zero. So this catalyst, it catalyzes only spontaneous reactions for which delta Z value is less than zero. Next point is, this catalyst will not alter the equilibrium position of the reaction. Only it helps to reach the equilibrium position of the reaction faster than earlier. So that catalyst will not alter equilibrium position, but it helps to reach equilibrium faster than earlier. Now I will see this energy profile diagram for this positive catalyst and negative catalyst. Suppose if I take energy profile diagram for this one, and this will be your energy along y-axis, and this is the progress of reaction along the x-axis. We know that a reactant, this will first, it will form an unstable intermediate complex, then there is a formation of product here, because this unstable intermediate complex, this will decompose to give the product. Now we know that this is the activation energy required for the reaction, for the reactant. I will write it as activation energy 1. This is in the absence of what? Catalyst. Activation energy 1 is in the absence of catalyst. This is the amount of activation energy required for the reactant. In presence of catalyst, the path of the reaction will be changed. So that catalyst, it will provide an alternate pathway for the reaction, where that unstable intermediate complex is formed at this point, so that this will be the activation energy required for the reactant. I will call it as EA2, it is activation energy 2. So here, in presence of positive catalyst, what happens? Activation energy decreases, so that rate of the reaction will increase here. Suppose if you use a negative catalyst, again the path of the reaction will be changed, in which the activation energy will be increased, because this is the point where unstable intermediate complex will be formed here. So what is the activation energy for this one? Activation energy is EA3 it is. So this is activation energy required for the reactant in the presence of negative catalyst. Negative catalyst is there, then it will increase the activation energy, and thereby it decreases the rate of the reaction. If positive catalyst is there, then it decreases activation energy. As a result, what happens here? Rate of the reaction will increase. So always you keep in mind, if positive catalyst is there, then the activation energy will be decreased. For the reactant here, only this much amount of energy is required to form an unstable intermediate complex. So here less amount of energy is required, so that here product will be formed faster as compared to in the absence of catalyst here. So this is the EA1, activation energy required in the absence of catalyst. EA2 is what? Activation energy required in the presence of positive catalyst, and this is in the presence of what? Negative catalyst. So EA1, activation energy, this is in absence of catalyst. Absence of catalyst. And activation energy 2, this is in the presence of positive catalyst. In presence of positive catalyst. And activation energy 3, this is in the presence of negative catalyst. So what is the effect here? Positive catalyst, activation energy is decreased, and rate of the reaction will be increased. And in the negative catalyst, activation energy is increased, and the rate will be decreased here. So this is what the effect of catalyst on the rate of the reaction. So the next point is collision theory of reaction rates. Collision theory of reaction rates here. So according to this theory, a chemical reaction takes place due to collision between the reacting molecules here. So the first point about this theory is we have to concentrate on the collision frequency. So what is collision frequency here? Collision frequency. This collision frequency is nothing but the number of collision per second per unit volume of reacting mixture is called as what? Collision frequency. For example, if I take a reaction, that is two reactants A and B, they will undergo collision and they are giving some amount of products here. Now the number of collision between these two reacting molecules per second per unit volume of reacting mixture, that is called as what? Collision frequency. So the symbol for collision frequency is ZAB. ZAB is what? Number of collision between the A and B reactants here. Okay. The next point is effective collision. Effective collision. So these two are very, very important point to decide the rate of the reaction. Here, what is effective collision? The collision in which the reacting molecule, they collide with the sufficient kinetic energy and the proper orientation. Only such collisions are called as what? Effective collision. the collision in which the reacting molecule collide with the threshold energy, that is sufficient kinetic energy, and the proper orientation. Such collisions are called as what? Effective collision. In this case, these reacting molecule, they will collide with the threshold energy. They must collide with threshold energy, and they must collide with the proper orientation. Proper orientation. So such collisions are called as what here? Effective collision. Only effective collision leads to the formation of product. And here, those effective collisions are what? They are reacting molecules are colliding with threshold energy and proper orientation. Because whenever the reacting molecule collide with a sufficient kinetic energy and with a proper orientation, then only they will form an unstable intermediate complex, which on decomposition gives the product here. That's why only effective collision leads to the formation of the product. If the reacting molecules are colliding with proper orientation, then only there is a formation of product. Improper orientation, in this case, there is no formation of the product here. So for example, if I take only proper orientation leads to the formation of product, and improper orientation do not lead to the formation of the product. For example, if I take the reaction between this methyl bromide here, this is CH3Br plus this nucleophile OH minus, and here this is methyl group is partial positive and Br minus is what? Partial negative. This weak nucleophile Br minus, it is replaced by strong nucleophile OH minus, so that there is a formation of methyl alcohol plus Br is coming outside here. So in this one, there are two possibilities. That is, this is your methyl bromide. So these three hydrogens, they are connected to the carbon, and this carbon is connected to the Br. This is a partial negative charge, and this will be what? Partial positive charge. If OH minus a strong nucleophile attacks from this side, and this is being negative charged and this is also being negatively charged, what happens? They will repel each other and they will be bounced back. So this is not the proper orientation for the product formation here. So what happens? These two will be bounced back, so that this is not a proper orientation, and here no product will be formed because it is improper orientation. Because here negative and negative, they will undergo repulsion here. Suppose this OH minus, it attacks this carbon from the back end, then there is a formation of product, because this is a negative and this will be partial positive. Those will be attracted to each other, and that will be considered as a proper orientation, and which leads to the formation of the product here. So which can be represented like this. If OH minus attacks this carbon from the back end, then there is a formation of intermediate complex. So this is a hydrogen, and these two are again hydrogen, three hydrogen connected to the carbon, and this is OH minus. And now what happens? And this is the Br, and this is partial negative. And now this is called as what? Unstable intermediate complex, because here this carbon is having five bonds. So carbon cannot have five bonds here, and here it is having five bonds, means it is unstable. And in this unstable intermediate complex, OH minus and Br, these two are partially bonded to the carbon, and this is being unstable, it readily decomposes to give the product, so that this Br minus is going outside, and this OH minus is connected to the carbon here. So the product will be what here? CH3OH plus Br minus. So this is the proper orientation, which leads to the formation of the product, and this is improper orientation, because these two are what? Negatively charged, and hence they will repel each other, they will be bounced back, there is no formation of the product here. And here what happens? This is negative and this carbon will be positive, they are attracted to each other, and this is a powerful negative charge attracts this carbon atom, so that this partial negative charge will be eliminated outside. Now this is what? Proper orientation, and this is improper orientation. Proper orientation leads to the formation of the product. Improper orientation, there is no formation of the product here. Now rate of the reaction. So this will be your unstable intermediate complex. I will represent it like this. Now rate of this reaction is inversely proportional to the activation energy, and this is directly proportional to the collision frequency, that is ZAB, and this is directly proportional to the fraction of molecules which are having sufficient kinetic energy. This is called as a Boltzmann factor, already we have discussed here. So this rate of the reaction, it depends on what? Collision frequency, the number of collision between the reacting molecule and the proper orientation of the reacting molecule and the fraction of molecules which are having sufficient kinetic energy. So here, according to this collision theory of reaction rates, rate of the reaction, it is written as, this will be equal to Z into AB, that is ZAB nothing but the collision frequency between two reacting molecule A and B, and this will be what? E into, that is E raised to EA by RT, minus EA by RT. This is what? The fraction of molecule having sufficient kinetic energy, and this is the collision frequency. And another factor, that is probability factor, is introduced into this formula in order to account for the orientation of the molecules, whether they are colliding with the proper orientation or not. To account for that one, another factor, that is probability factor, is introduced into this formula. That will be, this is rate will be equal to P into collision frequency between the two reacting molecule AB and into E raised to minus EA divided by RT. So these three are the important factors which decides the rate of the reaction. This is a probability factor which account for the orientation of the colliding molecule, and this is the collision frequency, and this is what? A fraction of molecule having sufficient kinetic energy. So this is the probability factor. This will be your probability factor, and this will be collision frequency, and this will be a fraction of molecule with sufficient kinetic energy, fraction of molecule with the threshold energy, we can write. So these are the important factors which decides the rate of the reaction. That is, in order to increase the rate of the reaction, the collision frequency is an important factor here. If the collision is more, then the rate of the reaction increases. If they will collide with a proper orientation, then the rate of the reaction increases. If the fraction of molecule having sufficient kinetic energy, if that increases, again rate of the reaction will increase. So these are the important factors which decides the rate of the reaction. So this is about the collision theory of reaction rates here.